it's Mandy with QACTV. You've received this piece of paper. That means you've been summoned to jury duty. Don't worry, we're gonna show you that everything you need to know is right on this piece of paper. So there are two types of jury duty. Bruce here is gonna receive grand jury duty, while Chris is going to receive trial jury duty. Step one, gentlemen, read the paper front and back.
Mm-hmm. That's a lot.
Step two, you're gonna need to complete the form within 10 days because this is the only paper you're going to receive. Ooh. There's no more reminder letters coming.
Okay, but Mandy, what are these scissor things for?
Yes, Bruce, I'm so glad you asked. So you've decided you're gonna mail yours in.
Obviously.
The back here, you're gonna fill out the entire form.
Right.
Answering all of the questions that it asks on the form. And where the scissors are shown, you're going to cut that piece off, save that in your wallet because it has all of your directions for parking, inclement weathers, and all of your information, and then mail the top half back.
So mail the top, keep the bottom in my wallet or purse.
Yes.
For safety.
Yes.
Makes sense.
Now, what if people like myself like to use modern technology? What do I do?
I'm so glad you asked, Chris. Mm. So as you can see, at the B section, it states a website right there. You can go on and fill out the whole form.
You mean this website that is right here at the bottom of the screen?
Definitely, right there.
So I can go and I can fill out pretty much exactly the same juror qualification form and then just wait whilst keeping this entire thing in my wallet or purse.
Good point.
You've got detailed directions on where to go and where to park. There's the inclement weather policy. They even have your reporting number and service period dates listed. And to top it off, they provide a contact number and a website address to answer any lingering questions you may have.
Huh. Sounds like everything we need to know is right here.
Right on the paper, gentlemen.
That's grand.
Mandy, I have a question.
Sure, Chris.
I'm over 70 years of age.
Wow, you look great for 70.
Why, thank you, I moisturize. But anyway, I'm over 70 years old and I thought I was not supposed to be receiving jury notices anymore.
That is a good question. Mm-hmm. As you can see on the form here, it has two options you can fill out.
Oh, okay.
The first one, you can check to be exempt. Say you just didn't want to go in that time and do it at that point that they were having jury.
Mm-hmm. So I can check that box right there.
That box right there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But also you can check off to be exempt permanently because at the age of 70, you can be exempt from jury duty.
Okay, but I have to let them know that I want to be permanently or temporarily exempt by checking the box 20A or 20B.
Yes, you definitely have to check the box. But if you enjoy jury duty, they're always looking for volunteers.
Okay, cool. I'm gonna grab my nap.
Excuse me, Mandy. Grandpa, I have a question.
Sure, yeah.
I am actually going on vacation. I'm going to Germany. I'm very, very excited. I've had it planned for a long, long time, and it just happens to be at the exact same time I'm doing jury duty, which is probably what a lot of people out there have had that same problem. What do I do?
Definitely, but as this sheet here says, follow the bottom, a letter of explanation is required.
So all I need is proof?
Documentation, that's all you need. As it states right here, a letter of explanation.
And then I get to go to Germany.
Then you can go to Germany.
Wunderbar.
Hopefully this video answered all your questions about jury duty. Not everything answered? Follow the link below. Chris, I see you decided to join us.
Yeah, it was actually quite easy. All I had to do was call the jury line each night to see if I had to serve, and out of a month, I only served one day, today. It's been great.
Bruce, you joined us from Germany?
Oh yeah, I flew home early because I didn't want to miss this amazing local courtroom drama.
Come join us in the box.